Dave from Wellsby Roots. For those of you guys who watched my last video, you will know that I made a handle for a Mora 4.3 high carbon steel blade blank. And I'll show you the knife right now. Here she is here. So, in this video, we're going to be making a sheath for it. I was going to make an all-leather sheath. I've done that before. I'm not a great sheath maker, but I'm getting better every time I do it. But what I decided to do is, because I got so much of this wood left that I made the handle with, I've decided to make the sheath half leather and half wood. So the knife blade will actually slide into wood. And so I think it will look pretty sharp. The handle, or the sheath, will actually match the handle. So let's get started with that. Okay, so before I glue these two halves together, I'm gonna score right here on both sides, and that way it will give the epoxy something to grab onto. Otherwise, the surface is just too smooth. I'm gonna do that using my rasp. So the epoxy is completely dry now. It's not tacky, not sticky or anything else of the sort. So we'll see how the knife fits into it. So it's a good fit. Nice tight fit. Not gonna go anywhere. Now I'm going to sand down these edges, and I'm going to round the whole thing out. And then we'll be putting leather from here to here. So, see how it turns out. I'll get back to you. Alright guys, I didn't show it, but I actually made an entirely new block. Made it exactly the same way as I did the last one, but I didn't like the way it was fitting together. It wasn't fitting together properly. There was too much gaps, and then the difference too is with this block, I did use wood glue. So I used wood glue instead, and because the resin was really showing up here, and it was just like this black strip. So I really didn't like the way it was fitting together. I didn't like having this black almost look like a liner in here. So I took it apart. I tried sanding it. It wasn't working. I don't have a belt sander, so it's hard for me to, you know, really get a good smooth job. So this was the original block. It's done. This is the new block. It's glued together with wood glue. And I think this one's going to work out a lot better. So now I'm just going to be, everything's glued together, the knife fits in there well, it's nice and snug. You can see how snug it is, it doesn't come out. It doesn't come out at all. And so now all we're going to be doing is shaping this.
Okay, guys, it's been about 24 hours now, and the leather is completely dry. You can see that it started to take shape and form to the handle of the knife and to the sheath, the wooden sheath. So I'm just going to unclamp it. Very stiff. Peel this wood off of the leather. Stuck on there pretty good. You can see how it's really formed to the knife here. Take that off. Inside's dry. You can really see how it's formed there. It's pretty cool. So we're gonna go ahead and we'll unwrap the knife. I'm going to put this back on for a second. Okay. Now I'm just going to mark it here. This is the sheath, the wooden sheath. And I'm just going to mark it right at the bottom of the wooden sheath here. And the reason for that is I'm going to sand just a little bit, just enough. I'm going to sand the wooden sheath from here to here. And then we're going to use wood glue all the way around and glue this leather part of the sheath onto the wood, and that way it will adhere to that part and really hold in place. We don't want it coming off. So I'm just going to take this off and set it aside, protect it, and we'll give this a little bit of a sand. Okay, now that this is done being roughed up, I'm going to kind of trace out how my sheath here, or at least the leather part, is going to take shape. I know it's going to be difficult for you guys to see it, so you're just going to have to bear with me.
the holes are punched out for where the stitching is going to go. I want to punch out the larger holes, which will go here, along right along here where the handle is. And these holes are going to come together and form the belt loop, or where the belt would slide through, in order to wear this on your belt. And there you go, guys. There's the sheath basically done. Probably gonna put some protectant on the leather, but there you go. The stitching. I gotta tell you the truth. I'm kind of concerned about this back part, how well it will stand up. So I'll have to take it out into the field and test it. And if it doesn't stand up, then I'll have to come up with another design for it. But in the meantime, that's what we're going to go with. And I got to tell you, the sheath is tight. Like, there's just no way that knife's going to come out. Maybe over time, might loosen up a little bit, but we'll see. There she is. That's the Mora 4.3 carbon steel blade, handled and sheathed. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hope you got something out of it, as usual. I hope you guys learned something. I know I did. So leave comments, likes, dislikes, and let me know what you guys think. Okay? I'll catch you next time. Thanks for watching.